Hello and welcome to this short series. I'm Ben Brownlee, and we're going to be building a sonic boom effect with Adobe After Effects and the Boris effect suite. Now, the idea behind this series isn't that we all end up with the same effect. Instead, I'll be taking you through the four different stages to approach this type of shot, starting with part one, tracking and data prep with Mocha and Continuum. Part two is generating our simple sound waves with particle illusion. Part three is turning those sound waves into something more stylish with Sapphire. And finally, in part four, we add the finishing touches and bring it all together. So let's get started with creating the data that will drive the rest of the effect. So we're going to be working in After Effects, and we're going to be using a few different bits from the Boris effects suite. We're going to be using Continuum and Sapphire as the main filters that we're going to be working with, and I'm going to be doing the tracking in Mocha as well. Now, there are many ways of achieving this effect, and there are many sort of variations we can do with the same basic ideas. But let's see the different steps that I took to get this effect. And then we'll break these down into smaller bits. So the first thing I did is to sort of analyze this shot up and create the data that I'm going to be using to drive the actual effect itself. So in the first stage, we're going to be doing tracking. And then because this is a music driven effect, I'm also going to be using Beat Reactor to come in and analyze our beats up. The next stage is going to be about creating our sound waves. And I'm going to be using particle illusion for this. It's a nice and a straightforward way of working. So then the real fun starts to happen as we start to change up those sound waves using different filters. Then we're going to put everything together and recycle a lot of the work that we've done up until that point to create something close to our finished shot, where we come in and then end up with the final little tweaks. So those are the broad strokes about what we're going to do. So let's come in and actually break this down properly. So I'm going to start with my footage. I'm just going to create a new comp here, and this is just the untreated girl. And there's a couple of things that we're going to need. We're going to need tracking data for both of the speakers, because a lot of the effects that we're going to use are going to be driven by the center points of these speakers. So the particles are going to come from there, and some of the distortion is also going to come from there as well. So we get like a proper looking sort of sound wave. And the other thing we need to drive this is our music. And this music can be pretty much anything. So if I bring our music clip down, we'll just take a little look at the waveform. So we just need to find an interesting part of the music that is going to sort of drive the main effect. In After Effects, we can preview the music only just by pressing the period or the comma key on your number pad, depending on what type of keyboard you've got. We'll take that. That's as good a sort of starting point as any. Okay, and I'll turn the music off so we're not listening to it all the time, because that will drive you up the wall very, very quickly if we're just listening to, you know, 3 seconds on loop all the time. It's not particularly fun. Well, let's get our tracking done. So I'm going to come in and I'm going to apply Mocha to our clip. And because we just need tracking data, I could use Mocha AE, which is the bundled version of Mocha within After Effects, or Mocha Pro. It doesn't really matter which one we use. So I'll just use Mocha AE. So let's open up Mocha and get our tracking done. I'm using the Essentials workspace just to keep everything nice and clean. All right, and all I'm going to do is just create a shape around the boombox. Now, because Mocha's a planar tracker, using a sort of big shape like this that describes the whole area that we're tracking is going to give us a really solid track. And I'll just turn on my surface and the grid here, just so you can see what's happening. Now, because we've got some reflections going over here, if I was to just use a point tracker, that might get a little bit thrown off at certain areas. You'll also find that very soon, our shape goes off screen. And that's not causing too much of an issue for our planar tracker at all. So play that back. That's all looking nice. I didn't expect that to be tricky. Okay, so let's turn off the grid. Now, the data that we want to get out is actually going to be from the center of the speakers. So what I'm going to do is change my surface point here. And this is the tracking data that we're going to get out of Mocha. I don't really have to worry about getting all of this kind of lined up perfectly because we're not going to be doing a corner pin on it. The only thing that really makes a big difference is where that center point is going to be. As long as that center point's in the right place, I don't really care too much. In fact, I'm just going to move that up into the right place and you'll see that that center point is looking fine. So I'm going to call this one speaker left, on the left side of the screen. And let's duplicate this down at the bottom. And I'm going to call this one speaker right. Now, this is the other really nice thing about doing this as a planar track, is that we can very easily offset this over onto the other side now. And because we've taken in the motion of the entire front of this area, it doesn't matter that she's twisting the boombox up a little bit more. That's going to stay in exactly the right place. That's looking good to me. So now I've got my two speakers, speaker left, speaker right. Let's come out of Mocha now. So I want a place to hold this data and I'm going to create a couple of new null objects. So come up to layer, new null object. And null objects are fantastic because they're sort of helper layers. They don't get included in any renders. So we just use them to kind of hold and transfer data between different layers and effects. Let's call this one speaker left. And let's create another one, duplicate that one, and we'll call that one speaker right. And let's make our tracking data hop onto the right speaker, shall we? In the Mocha AE plugin, we'll create our track data. I'll take the speaker right because that's the one we had. And that's created the track data for me here. I'm going to just export out the transform because I don't need all the rest of the corner pin data. And we will put that into the speaker right null. Apply that export. There we go. Our speaker right pops into the right place. Going to come to the other one, create track data again. Do the same thing for speaker left. Everything else stays the same. I'm just going to apply this data now to the speaker left layer. Apply. Boom. We have our tracking points in there. Excellent. Let's bring those down to the bottom and turn them off because we don't actually need to see them at all. I'm going to create another null object. There we go. And this one's just going to be the sort of a placeholder for the music data. And I'll just call this one music data. And this is going to be really useful in about a minute and a half's time. Okay, let's apply another effect to our video layer. And we're going to come and use our first continuum effect. And this is under the time category and it's called Beat Reactor. And Beat Reactor is a great way of coming in and creating data out of a music layer. So in After Effects, we have to tell it what the host layer is going to be. And we can just say, catch me at them all, which is the name of the clip. I'll bring my music data underneath because we don't really need it to do anything right now. And I'll change my view mode to graph over layer. So we can see the girl in the background as well. Okay, so what Beat Reactor is doing now, as I do a quick RAM preview on this, it's showing us the different frequencies that make up our music. So we have our bass frequencies over here, our treble, and the stuff in the middle is our midtones. So what I want to do is have it sort of react mainly to when we get the big hits of bass. Let's just hit the, would help, let's turn on the music so I can preview it. And I And we can see that these frequencies here, these bands here, correspond to the drums. If we go too far or too much lower here, we just get the bass, the doom, and that stays up high. Like, you see that doom, that's going to be that area there. And when that comes in, that's not going to go anywhere. So we want a bit of movement. And with the HUD turned on in the effect, I can just drag these sampler corner points over here to sort of just pick up those frequencies that I'm interested in. And if you look at the right-hand side, this is showing us our scale of how much those are being used. So if it goes down to zero, it means it's not there at all. And you can see that over here. So if I bring this down, so we always sort of have just a little bit happening. Let's just preview that. And I'll turn off the music. It's already driving me a little bit loopy. So let's focus on what's happening over on the right-hand side. You can see there's nice movement going up and down here. And it's that movement, that sort of pulsing movement that we want. If this was always at the top, then the effects we connect it to are always going to be, you know, kind of on all the time at full pace. If there's nothing, then it's always going to be off and it's going to be really dull. So we want this kind of beating movement. And now we get a chance to kind of output it as something. And we can get really fancy with this. Things like fall off, so we can have it, you know, falling off a little bit softer. So you can see it's not going boom, boom, boom. It's kind of got a little bit of a fall off over half a second. Or if we do that over 0.2 seconds. It just helps to kind of smooth things out a little bit. And we still keep in that nice sort of movement, but we're not getting like kind of just sharp movement all the time. If you really wanted to, we can generate up, you know, different outputs that correspond either to different frequencies or just different ranges. But I'll just generate output A. And if I go down to my video layer where it's on, hit U, and we can see the values that it's created down at the bottom here. And we want to copy these to our other layer, just so we've got, you know, like a nice place for these values. So I'm just going to click on the word output value A to select all of the keyframes, hit copy. And I'm going to come to the music data null object that I created. And I'm going to add another effect, which is going to be just an expression control, and it's going to be a slider control. I'm just going to add a keyframe here, and I can paste in that data down on the timeline. So let's turn off the visibility on Mocha E and the Beat Reactor. We might not have anything visible yet, but actually we've done most of the prep work that we need to start coming in and driving the effects. Before we start adding our sound waves though, I'm going to show you one last little thing. And come back into Mocha. And we're going to be using the Mocha that's built into some of the other effects in a little bit. So what I'm going to do is just export out this project. And I'm going to create a new folder. And we'll call this one Mocha Exports. And we'll call this one Boombox. We'll save that one. So now we have that Mocha project available to us. And that Mocha data we've already created available to us in different plugins and different effects. So we don't have to redo lots of data. This is the end of part one. Join me in part two of this series where we learn how to create our basic sonic boom using particles from Particle Illusion. Thanks for joining me for now. If you want to try this out on your own footage, then head on over to boriseffects.com and download a free trial version of all the software you've seen here. You can also learn more about the Boris Effects suite and learn through the hours of free video tutorials of all of the Boris Effects products.